Sunshine Sammy, Ernest Morrison. The Crisis, January 1929. In the city of New Orleans, slightly more than a decade and a half ago, Ernest Morrison was born, the first child of Mr. and Mrs. Joseph Morrison. About 6 months later, Mr. Morrison, a government employee in the Southwest, was granted a leave to California on account of trouble with his eyes. Later, the interesting little family was united in Los Angeles. Despite the trouble with his eyes, Mr. Morrison was fascinated by the rapidly growing moving picture industry, and had no difficulty in seeing clearly the possibilities for those who would begin at the bottom and work hard. With this vision and the determination to succeed, this ambitious father coached his young hopeful, and at the age of a year and a half, he began his moving picture career as an infant extra for the princely compensation of a dollar and a half a week. This humble beginning was immediately crowned with success. A short time after his first appearance, the promising little extra was featured as Sunshine Sammy co-star with baby Marie Osborne in a regular photoplay. For 3 years following, the little boy was featured in 2 and 3 reel comedies in which Harold Lloyd and Snub Pollard played the important adult roles. At the age of 7 years, he became the star of the Our Gang comedies and was featured first in The Little Pickaninny. His sister, the original Farina, created a stellar role in her own right in the gang. Movie fans the world over recall the many fine productions in which this little star was featured for about 7 years. It was quite an interesting trail from the role of an infant extra at a dollar and a half a week to a juvenile star at $550 a week. At this, apparently the zenith of his career, it seemed that his producers wanted to feature one of the lesser lights to share the hard-earned and thoroughly deserved honors of Sunshine Sammy. This arrangement was refused outright by the father, and as a result, his little boy left the screen. His actions in this particular case were criticized very severely by those who knew the facts, and perhaps even more by those who knew nothing about the situation. However, Mr. Morrison felt that his son should remain the star of the group because by his own ability, he had contributed more than anybody else to establish Our Gang in the hearts of movie fans. During the 3 months following his withdrawal from the screen, much time was spent in rest, and some in the preparation of a vaudeville act conceived by Mr. Morrison. In going over the correspondence necessary to secure bookings, Mr. Morrison considered best the offer made by a Houston, Texas theater manager. Thinking that he had closed a deal to play in one of the smaller theaters to an audience more or less critical, his party journeyed to the Texas city. Imagine their surprise when they received a rousing greeting at the station and all along the route of the gala parade, including 14 automobiles crowded with enthusiastic admirers. The original engagement, which was for 3 days, netted the team $450. The act went over in such fine style that the engagement was extended to cover a period of 12 days at an advanced figure. This excellent beginning was followed by engagements in New Orleans, Birmingham, and Atlanta. In the Georgia capital, Sunshine Sammy was a guest of the Chamber of Commerce and appeared in a Lowe's Theater, the first Negro act in 35 years. The Atlanta Constitution, an outstanding Southern daily, was most generous in praise of the star. The act at this time was bringing $750 a week. The publicity given by the Constitution helped to make easy lucrative engagements in Nashville, Louisville, Chicago, Detroit, and Cleveland. The Billboard joined the chorus in singing the praises of the now famous vaudeville star, and the theatrical world was alert enough to get on the bandwagon. Mr. A. Feinberg, well-known booking agent in New York City, was attracted by this extraordinary publicity and made special efforts to secure the booking rights of the new star. Consequently, after a series of telegrams, long-distance telephone calls, and letters, a contract was secured with Faye Circuit, handled through Keith's agency, and the act opened at Faye's Rochester Theater in May 1925, at a salary of $1,250 a week. Then followed successful engagements throughout the East and Middle West. In the fall of 1925, the act was booked by the Keith Albee Orpheum Circuit. For the 3 years ending May 1928, these contracts were in force. In May of this year, a contract was signed with Lowe's Circuit, which will include the season of 1928-29. On the Orpheum and on the Lowe's Circuit, despite the other nationally known acts carried, Sunshine Sammy's act has always been featured as the headliner on the bill. Contracts for this year include engagements for the Vitaphone Talking Pictures. Thus, we follow an interesting ascent from a dollar and a half a week to $1,250 a week and more. Obviously, this modest, capable, and industrious young star will reach even greater magnitudes. The wide-awake father is giving his famous son instructions in the business end of his career, as well as in the entertainment features. Father and son make a fine team off, as well as on the boards, and fortunately, both realize that there are still heights to be reached.